contact visits? Well, sounds like she's in jail. Why can't I have her back proper?
Now, just a minute. As I said, you'll be allowed contact visits and you'll be able to take her out one full day a week. That's until you can prove that you can look after her properly. And when you can prove that, you'll be able to have her full time with no interference. Look, it would be a lot easier if you had a home and a job to go to, but at the moment you've got neither. Now, Mick told me he proposed to you. I suggest you think about it very carefully. He seems to really care for you. And it could be the answer to all your problems.
You helped me once before, Bea. You made me realise what an idiot I was being. And then you talked about the importance of family love. Well, that's why I thought perhaps you might help me now.
Help you? Help you how?
Dad really respects you. He might listen to you, Bea. Will you talk to him? Try and persuade him to go back to Mum?
Seems to me you've got things screwed up. If your mother cared about him as much as you say she does, she wouldn't expect him to give up something that means one hell of a lot to him.
Yeah, but you can still love someone and hate what they do.
Not if it's part of them.
Then you won't talk to him.
No way.
You don't know what my mother's been through because of his stupid job.
His stupid job is what straightened you out. And if your mother can't handle it, then he is better off without her. And he'd be mighty proud of you knowing you were here broadcasting his private life behind his back.
You're going to tell him?
No, because I've got more respect for his feelings than you have. And I wouldn't want him knowing his daughter is no better than her mother.
You're just saying that because you're sweet on him yourself. And if he gave up his job, you'd never see him again. I'm not going to let you keep them apart, Bea.
I had no idea I had so much influence over him.
Wait by the gates for an officer, Smith.
A woman would be a fool if she thinks a man would be happy just to grab a few minutes with her. Without a second to themselves.
Depends how much he cares. And he could care about her one hell of a lot. Do you know what I feel about you, B. Smith? You're a mixture of anger and fury and a lot of strength. You're a survivor. But you've still got a lot of softness and honesty and warmth. A woman like you is never going to know what it's like not to feel. I reckon I'm a very lucky man even to have met you.
Hey.
Hey, you okay? What's wrong, Bea? We all used to be mates. Now Dora's gone off, keeping to herself, and you're not speaking to any of us?
Do you think Ken Pierce is the sort of man who'd say things he didn't mean?
I reckon he'd play straight with anyone.
That's how I figured it.
What's he been saying to you, Bea?
You know, Lizzie, after you've been here for a while, and there's something you can't have, you start telling yourself you don't want it anymore anyway, right?
Yeah, that's like me with the booze, only it doesn't work.
Well, no more. I'm going to grab what I can. I found something special and I'm not going to let it go.
What are you doing here, Smith?
Well, as a matter of fact, I was waiting for an officer, but don't let me keep you, Vera. I think I'll wait for one who's almost human.
You like the corridors so much, I could quite easily have you scrub them.
I want to see the governor, it's private.
You have your privacy one day a month, Smith, and I'll decide if you can see the governor or not.
I really must get your goat, Vera, knowing we're allowed to see our friends and families for a couple of hours in privacy without you perving on us. And not even be able to read our mail anymore.
I have my ways of knowing what's going on, Smith. For instance, I had a very interesting chat with Debbie Pierce this afternoon. I was under the impression she looked up to you. Strange how attitudes change, wouldn't you say? But there again, it's one thing to admire toughness in here, but another to think that her father might be getting involved. You're not even good enough for an ex-crim in her eyes.
I think I'll open the laundry with her some fresh air.
She's going to make sure he doesn't visit you again. And she's got a week to do it.
Was that necessary, Vera?
I beg your pardon?
You know what I'm talking about. Now, no matter what you think of Bea, how dare you be so callous?
She wouldn't tell me why she wanted to see the governor.
And you say malicious things like that to her? Who do you think you are?
Since when has a parole officer been allowed to wander around the prison on her own?
You can check that with Mrs. Davidson.
It still doesn't give you the right to tell an officer how to do her job.
All right, Vera. But if you don't take Smith to see the governor, I intend to tell her that you've been deliberately baiting a prisoner.
Come on, Dad. Look, I'm sure Mum had come. Why didn't you ask?
I don't think I'd be any help, love.
Well, try. It'd sound much better if you said you wanted her here.
Look, if she comes, it's because you need her to help with the shopping. It's got nothing to do with me, and I mean it.
I told her that newspaper article was a whole lot of lies and that you're suing them.
And I suppose she said, that's what you get for working in prisons, eh?
No, but she was still upset. Well, how do you think she'd feel, reading you and Bea are having an affair? Anyhow, I said you were just visiting her because you felt sorry for her. Well, I had to say something.
Hey, back up a bit. What's this feel sorry for her business?
Well, aren't you?
She's a friend, Debbie.
Then you can write to her.
I never expected to hear that coming from you.
And what about Mum? Don't you care about her feelings?
She's only worried about what her friends think.
Well, what am I going to do? I'll be the first bride in history without a thing to wear.
Look, if you want to ring your mother, fine. Maybe she can get the day off work.
One day's not enough.
Okay, she's welcome to stay for a couple of days, but on the condition she mentions nothing about my job, okay? But I doubt if she'll come.
I've been thinking about what Debbie said, Mrs. Davidson, and I think I should straighten her father out on a few things.
Such as?
Well, I'm going to be in here a lot longer, and I don't want any man hanging out waiting for me, especially one with a family.
I'm not sure I follow you.
I'll lay my cards out, Mrs. Davidson. There was a time when I did feel something for Ken Pearce. And I may be wrong, but I think if he keeps coming in here and seeing me, he might start reading things that aren't there. And you know how I feel about women who muck around with married men. Hell, I wouldn't even be in here if it wasn't for some bitch trying to spit up me and my old man.
I was under the impression the Pearces had been separated.
Yeah, but I don't want Debbie thinking that I'm making things worse. I need to see him, Mrs. Davidson, for Debbie's sake. Oh, the kid's getting married in a week or two and she'll be stewing about it otherwise.
You can always write to him, Smith. Tell him you don't want to see him anymore.
I really need to see him face to face, Mrs. Davidson. I know I'm not entitled to it, but if I could have an unsupervised visit... Well, there are some things you just can't say in front of an officer. Not to a man like Ken Pearce. And it's the least I can do for Debbie.
I don't know how it'll turn out. I'm just going on how Mum cooked it. She said it was your favourite.
I'm sorry she's not coming, love. But I did try to warn you.
Well, she might have if you'd spoken to her. Well, I think the whole thing stinks. Two grown-up people who keep hurting each other because of a stupid job. If you really loved each other, one of you ought to give in.
That's probably what's wrong. Hello? Bea?
I can't talk long. I need to see you. Do you think you could drop by tomorrow? Mrs. Davidson's okayed it. It's important. Thanks.
You might have fooled Mrs. Davidson, Smith, but I've known you for too long. Whatever you're planning, I intend catching you out.
Why, Vera, I don't know what you're talking about.
You said you were going to come shopping with me and that we'd have lunch together.
Yeah, but Bea wouldn't have called unless it was important, love. But don't worry, we can still fit everything in.
Don't bother. I'm not part of your job. Look, she's just trying to...
Trying to what? Debbie?
Nothing. Did she mention me?
No. Should she? Look, you can come too if you like.
No, thanks.
Debbie's kidding herself if she thinks they're going to get back together again. So I can't ruin something that isn't there, can I?
It's not going to be easy for you, Bea. For you or Ken.
Well, I don't care how little we see of each other. It's going to be more than I've got now. Besides, after tomorrow, I just might be seeing more of him.
Hey, Chrissie.
Mm.
How long's Mick been out of jail?
6 months.
Oh, well, then how come it's taken him till now to come and see you?
I don't know, do I? He said something about wanting to get set up proper, you know, so he could offer me some kind of future, I suppose.
Oh, sounds like a real nice bloke.
He's okay.
Did you really lie about the kid being his?
Why don't you go and eat some poison cheese, Mouse?
What are you going to say to him tomorrow, Ben?
Dry up, Lizzie.
You're getting another visit, aren't you? Well, if you can, so can I.
Oh, no, you don't. If everyone goes asking Dave for extra visits, she'll stop them for all of us.
And what makes you so special?
My friend's respectable.
He's still an ex-crim, though, isn't he? Just like Mick. Except, of course, he works for the Screws. I suppose that's why you like each other so much. You're both bloody top sucks, aren't you, really? Get out of my way.
Latham, break it up! All right, who started this? Well? All right, suit yourself. Not going to look too good on your parole report, is it, Latham? As for you, Smith, I'm sure we can find a way of cooling you down. Now, off to yourselves, both of you.
Oh, brother, what the hell is wrong with Bea lately?
Oh, she's fallen to that Ken Pearce, that's all.
What?
Yeah. Don't say I said anything, Jude. She'd kill me if I told you.
Yeah, well, I knew she was attracted to him, but that's ridiculous. I mean, what good's that going to do her stuck in here?
Yeah, she's right out of her depth now, right?
The whole evening's ruined just because I lost my temper.
Don't worry about it. Let's go out to eat.
I feel too rotten.
Okay, I'll get some takeaway. Be about 10 minutes. Oh, and I promise I won't breathe a word about that to Peter.
Hello, Mum. Look, please, you've got to come. No, no, it's not just the shopping. I didn't tell you everything before, but... It's Dad. If you don't do something about it, you're going to lose him. Dad? Dad? Ah, he must have just left, but he said he'd be home for lunch.
You mean he'll be with this woman all morning?
Well, he's got to visit Pentridge too. Hey, would you like a cup of tea?
Oh, no thanks. I had one on the train.
Oh, well, I'll put this in my room.
No, leave it there. I might not be staying.
But, Mum, I've arranged...
I can always stay in a hotel. Why didn't you tell him I was coming?
I wanted you to surprise him. Well, he said you'd be welcome.
I thought you said you liked this woman.
I did. At least I felt sorry for her more than anything. But that was before I found out she was trying to split you and Dad up.
Thought we'd managed that on our own.
If you can't stand him, then why don't you give him a divorce?
Because he's never asked for one. And one day he'll come to his senses.
He won't as long as Bea's got her hooks into him.
Look, Ken would never get involved with a criminal.
That's his job, isn't it? And if you thought that, how come you believed that story in the paper? Look, you don't know her, Mum. When she sets out to get something, she gets it. They've got a lot in common, too. She's serving almost as much time as he did.
You don't have to remind me about his past. I know. I lived through it.
That's what this is about. That's what got him into trying to make prisons better. And why you don't want anything more to do with him. Well, isn't it?
Oh. I don't know. I don't know what to think anymore.
Well, you better make up your mind, Mum. Because if you don't show Dad you still want him back, it's as good as letting her have him.
Mm-hmm. Thanks for coming.
Oh, you've only got to ask, you know that. It must be important for Mrs. Davidson to agree to a visit so soon. Not to mention the privacy, eh? Wentworth's changed a lot since the days of the storeroom. Mm-hmm. I heard you got yourself in a bit of strife. Is that what you wanted to see me about?
Word travels fast, isn't it? I hope Debbie didn't mind you coming to see me.
Debbie?
How is she?
Oh, just pre-wedding jitters.
Well, at least you'll have the whole family together on the day. You don't talk about your wife very much.
There's nothing much to say. That's past history.
She and Debbie seem pretty close.
Well, Marion had to bring her up by herself. And work. It wasn't easy for her.
Is that why you never got a divorce? Because of Debbie?
Marion's never asked me for one. She's Catholic, but I rather fancy she enjoys the sound of being married rather than the actual state. But like I said, that's past history. Now, what about you?
Oh, you know me. I'm always bound to get into strife. Keeping the others straightened out.
Look, B, forget about everybody else. If you want to beat the system, love, you've got to join it. That's what I did. I forgot about myself and I played the screws game. Now, it got me out 5 years earlier and it gave me a purpose.
You know, the other day when you said you thought I should get involved in prisoners' rights? Well, I got to thinking about it. I wouldn't mind giving it a go. But I couldn't do it alone.
You could do anything you put your mind to. Well, I couldn't be happier.
Wouldn't it be easier if you stuck around, though? I mean, for a bit of support?
No, I'd like to, love, but my hands are tied.
You could always untie them. I don't know whether I mentioned it or not, but we've got a new teacher.
Yeah, I met him, Andrews. He seems a go-getter.
Yeah, well, I think he might be interested in learning a few things from you himself. And Mrs. Davidson seems to listen to him.
It's all right for you lot, isn't it? Sitting there telling us to keep our noses clean. But we've got to live here, haven't we? I mean, how do you think it feels when we see women like Bea getting extra visits? And all we've got is to think about our men. Once a bloody month, if you're lucky, you might get to hold hands.
At least I'll be able to explain to the board that you're under a great deal of emotional pressure.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Put my feelings out on the table for everyone to leer at.
Sexual frustration is a problem in all prisons.
They're going to think I'm a raving nympho. I mean, what would you know anyway, going home to your husband? I'm sorry, Mrs. Morris. You're not just stringing me along, are you? I mean, you won't ruin it for me when you get in front of the board, will you? Get your own back after all this time?
I meant that I understood. But if you have any doubts, we may be able to get you another parole officer.
Oh, no, I want to stick with you. I've been thinking about Mick. And I'm going to marry him.
Well, you don't sound very happy about it.
Yeah, well, I could do worse, couldn't I? And it will help me to get out of here, won't it?
It's pointless marrying him just to get out, Chrissie. I mean, if the marriage breaks down, well, you won't be getting Elizabeth straight away. You have to prove that you've got a suitable home environment before welfare hands her over.
I'll do anything for my child.
The last time we spoke, I seem to recall your mentioning that apartment was still in the dark ages.
Well, you've certainly made a lot of changes since then, Mrs. Davidson.
And you think we've made enough to reinstate you?
If you and Mr. Andrews approve, I'd like to come back here as an advisor, even temporarily.
Have you spoken to Smith about this?
Yes, and I think I can do more for her working with her here than just visiting her as a friend.
Do you think she'll benefit from the new program?
Yes. She needs an objective, something to work towards. That laundry down there is hardly an outlet for a woman of her intelligence and capabilities.
Mr. Pearce, if you do return, and that depends entirely on my discussion with Mr. Andrews, you must realize that your relationship with Smith will be the same as any other staff member to an inmate.
Yes, of course. Debbie, I'm home. All set to go. Debbie?
Hello, Ken.
Marion.
Isn't it great, Dad? Hope you don't mind.
No. Well, at least this gets me off the hook. I won't have to go sitting in boutiques for hours. When did you arrive?
Oh, a couple of hours ago.
Well,
you're looking well.
So are you. Did you have much trouble getting off work?
Oh, I'm head of my department now. That helps.
That's great.
And you? Work seems to be agreeing with you.
Well, it couldn't be better.
Good. Debbie tells me you've been at Wentworth all morning.
Yes, I shall be working there again. It's only a temporary job, but we'll see how it goes.
What'll you be doing?
You mean you're interested?
Well, if I'm going to be here for a couple of days, I certainly don't intend to avoid the subject. Oh, that's if you don't mind. We've got quite a few things to discuss. About Debbie's wedding.
Yes, of course. I'll be working with the teacher they've got out there. We're setting up new programs for the long-serving women. Trying to get them more involved in running their own lives.
Hmm. Quite a responsibility. Hope they appreciate you. B. Smith's a long-serving prisoner, isn't she?
Yes.
I read that newspaper article very carefully.
Marion, if you think I'm about to defend myself,
Look,
you're wrong.
There's no need.
I'm hungry. What say we go and eat?
I'm sure your father's got things to do.
Oh, but Mum...
And we've got a lot of shopping to catch up on.
Yes, why don't you take the car, love? I've got a few things here I can fix up.
Thanks.
Look, if you're going to be in this evening, I could cook us a family dinner.
That'd be nice.
Bye.
Bye, love.
Uncensored letters.
Yes?
I'd like to see B. Smith, please.
Visiting hours are over.
Oh, I didn't know. Look, I'm from out of town. I won't get a chance to see her again.
Oh, it'll have to be cleared with the governor. Name?
Marion Pearce.
You're not related to Ken Pearce by any chance?
I'm his wife.
Oh, well, in that case, I think we can make an exception. Sign in over here and put your address, your city address. Smith's very lucky to have a whole family so interested in her. Do you know her well?
We've never met.
Debbie would have told you all about her, surely.
Oh, a little.
I hope you have more success than Debbie. Well, getting your husband to realize that he's wasting his time trying to help Smith sort. Well, that article in the paper must have been very embarrassing for you.
I know my husband well enough to know it was a pack of lies.
Yes, of course. No doubt Debbie's told you that Smith doesn't quite see it that way. Take Mrs. Pearce to the interview room. I'll get Smith for you.
I've
got another visitor, Smith. Mrs. Pearce. Well, don't you want to see her? She's certainly really very interested in meeting you.
Then I'd better not keep the lady waiting.
Just a word of advice. This won't be an unsupervised visit. But then you've got nothing to worry about, have you? You did tell Mrs. Davidson that you and Mr. Pearce have a working relationship. Of course, if there was anything else going on between you two, he'll only have to be banned again. Oh, by the way, you'll be pleased to know that she gave her husband's address. Here's your mail.
Get out of my lodge.
You got another one, Dor.
Give us it.
Hey, what's up?
Mind your own bloody business.
Oh, I don't know. This place is like a bloody Secret Service.
It's all this talk about men. That's what's got her, poor little kid. She's got no one.
Well, someone's writing to her.
Yeah.
Listen, what do you think Vera's on about with B?
I don't know. But it's like letting two hungry dogs loose at each other and then keeping one tied up.
I'll take over now, thank you, Mrs. Knox.
I'm Marion Pearce. Mrs. Marion Pearce.
Ken's telling me a lot about you.
I doubt that. But my daughter's told me a lot about you.
Is that what brought you out of the woodwork?
I've come for the wedding. It's going to be a family affair.
You never thought about your family when you left your husband stewing inside on his own all those years.
Just because you've got a prison sentence in common doesn't mean you understand a man like Ken. If you did, you'd realize how loyal he is.
Why have you come here, Mrs. Pearce? You don't care about Ken, his work, how he thinks or feels or anything else.
And you do.
Your husband could have come out of jail with a chip on his shoulder a mile wide. A wife who never went near him. Who kept his kid away from him. Not to mention a little thing like what being inside does to you. But he didn't. Instead, he's trying to help people in the same boat he was in. And I respect that. And I intend to help him in his work as much as I can. He needed you years ago. He doesn't need you anymore.
Perhaps.
Kind of figured you'd say yes, so I got it all set up. New flat, everything you'll need, even a washing machine two floors down, and I'm going to do the second bedroom up for when we get Liz.
Don't start calling her that. Her name's Elizabeth.
Oh, yeah. I got a bonus for finishing a building job early yesterday, so there's no worries about money. And I've been picking up some bits and pieces from the site so I can start making her a few toys.
Look, I'm not even out of here yet, and you don't have to do everything by yourself.
Just getting a bit ahead of myself. What do you reckon, Mrs. Morris? What are her chances?
Oh, getting better by the minute, judging by everything you've organised. You must understand that if Chrissie is paroled, the parole period can be anything up to the time left to serve. Now, that's 5 years. It's a long time.
Don't worry. I'll make sure she keeps her nose clean.
I couldn't do that by myself. You're not my babysitter. I've been looking after myself for years.
What do I say?
I'm all uptight. I've got to go and see the parole board in the morning.
Oh, look, that's me when I was 5.
Yeah, cheeky brat even then, weren't you?
Oh, hey, Mum, come and have a look at these.
I've seen them a dozen times, Debbie.
I told Mum to bring them so you could make a proud father speech at the reception. Tell him what a cute kid I was. Oh, look, there's you and Mum just after you got married.
It's truth, will you look at that?
Hey, you look like a rocker.
Well, he was.
Oh, that was the fashion.
Let's face it, Ken, you were a bit of a larrikin.
Oh, you don't look much better, Mum.
Oh, thanks. I was only 17. I thought I looked wonderful.
Your mother was pretty wild too, you know, and she had a temper to match.
Hey, Ken.
It's true.
Oh, I bet you had plenty of fun, though.
I didn't know you kept all of these.
Had to have something to remind Debbie she had a father.
Yeah, there were quite a few gaps, eh?
Oh, perhaps you better put them away now, Debbie.
Sure.
You know, it's never too late to make up some of those years to her.
And how do I do that? By giving up my job?
Well, at least the reminder wouldn't be there.
The reminder's here, inside. Now, the only way I can live with that is by doing what I do.
I went to see B. Smith today.
You what? What the hell did you do that for?
Curiosity, I suppose. I wanted to know why you spend so much time with her. I wanted to understand.
Understand what?
You don't need that job. You've got enough on your plate as it is. There had to be more to it than helping one more prisoner.
Marion, you don't know what you're talking about. You had no right to go behind my back. But there is more to it than that. I respect that woman and I care what happens to her.
Did it ever occur to you that that woman's not interested in your precious job? That it's you she's interested in? That she's in love with you? A woman can always sense that in another woman. Oh, that doesn't bother me. It's your attitude I'm interested in. You're too defensive about her. I think you should examine your own motives pretty carefully, Ken. I think you're more involved with B. Smith than you care to admit.
Do you mean to say you've never told him how you feel? Ever?
I reckon he knows.
Why, what's he said to you?
Enough.
But if his wife's living with him again...
She's just here to help Debbie out, Lizzie. She's ancient history.
From what you've told me, I reckon she's just after updating herself a bit.
Well, why would she want to change her mind after all this time? That's... Anyway, he wouldn't want her back.
One thing, losing your fella to a job. But if they think it's to another woman... I've seen women turn from freezing to boiling overnight.
Go to sleep, Lizzie. I don't know what you're talking about.
It must be nice to have your wife at home, Mr. Pearce.
Just a short visit.
She's more understanding than most wives would be under the circumstances.
I'd appreciate it very much, Miss Bennett, if you kept your nose out of my private life.
Then tell your family not to drag it into the prison, Mr. Pearce.
Ah, Ken, we've got a couple of hours before classes, if that's all right. I'd like to get on with it straight away.
Yeah, fine with me.
Vera, could you send B. Smith along when you've got a minute?
You did understand the governor's instructions, didn't you?
What?
Smith must be supervised at all times. Mr. Pearce is not a permanent staff member.
What did Dad say this morning?
Oh, he was gone when I got up.
He's not going to stop working in prisons, is he?
I'm not sure that he should.
What?
Well, perhaps it is too much part of him.
Then you're not going to stay?
One of us has to give in. He can't. And I'm not sure that I can either.
Okay. Give him a divorce. Then where will you be? Look, once Pete and me married, well, we could be shifted anywhere. I'm not going to be around forever, Mum. You'll have no one.
Oh, I've got my job, friends.
Working in a department store. I can see you're still there when you're 60.
Look, I'm not going back to your father just because I'm afraid of being lonely in my old age. Always assuming he wants me back, which is very doubtful.
You haven't even asked him. Look, I saw the way you looked at each other last night. You can't tell me you two don't care.
Our marriage has been a farce. In 20 years, we've had less than 2 years together.
That doesn't change the way you feel. All the more reason you shouldn't waste any more time.
I'm not sure I can break B. Smith's hold on him. And I don't think I want to.
You look real beautiful, B.
Well, you can't catch anything with a bit of honey.
Well, in your case, you'd need the old bloody jar, wouldn't you?
Has your bloke had his eyes tested lately, or doesn't he mind tarts?
Oh, well, when you got it, you got it.
You don't need honey, I can tell you that.
Shut up, just shut up, all of you. Make me sick. We're not all interested in hearing about your love life, you know.
All right, Chrissie, it's time.
Good luck, kid.
You give them what it takes, love.
If the unsupervised visits are going to cause this much trouble, look, can't you see you're only giving the officers reason to stop them? And that wouldn't be very fair on the married women, would it?
All right. What is eating you?
Nothing.
You heard what Mrs. Morris said. Someone like Vera is just itching to stop these visits.
Yeah, well, it's all right for you, isn't it? You're allowed to go on a visit and you're not even married.
Smith, you're wanting the library. What if that's to impress Mr. Pearce? You can forget it. You'll be supervised the whole time.
Why, Vera, you know I'm only interested in furthering my education.
You look ridiculous.
Words of wisdom from Miss Frozen Features.
If we can get the businesses interested, that means job security, a place back in society, and it impresses the parole board.
I've got a few long-term ideas on that score myself, if you're interested. They're still at the drawing board stage, but I'd like your opinion.
Sure, fine.
They're in the car.
Do you want me to come with you, or what?
No, don't worry. If I see Miss Bennett, I'll say I locked you in separate rooms.
Well, I think this should work out well. He seems a decent sort of a bloke.
Oh, we've had a few run-ins.
I wouldn't mind betting you can trust him. Took you a while to trust me, remember?
Means a lot to trust someone.
Mm-hmm.
How long's your wife staying with you?
Well, she's probably gone back already. She had no right coming here.
Well, I'd do the same thing in her shoes. She's your wife. She'd be a fool not to regret missing all those years with you.
I doubt it.
Would it make any difference?
In what way?
If she wanted you back.
Well, I used to wish like crazy she'd change her mind and come back. Not anymore. You can't live in the past forever, love.
Spending a lifetime with someone doesn't mean as much as just a few hours with the right person, you know.
There's no point regretting something you can't change.
You taught me that. You gave me something to believe in again. There's nothing more important than two people caring for each other. You're lucky if it happens to you once. And it's worth holding on to no matter what you have to do for it.
Do you know what I like about you?
You did tell me once.
You are a very special woman. Don't ever change. Oh, I thought you would have left this morning.
I almost did.
Debbie?
She's out.
Oh.
I wanted to have a talk. About us. Do you want a divorce?
Well, there's not much point in staying married, is there?
Unless you wanted to try again. Oh. But I was forgetting. You're involved with that woman, aren't you?
That woman and I had 5 minutes alone together this morning. And in that time, she put me straight on a few things. Namely, you and me. She spoke about regrets. The right person, about hanging on to something that really matters.
Oh, and she really matters, I suppose.
Yes, yes, but not in the way you think. Oh, boy, you and your intuition. Look, I gave her something to believe in, and that's what she was trying to give me. And here's me believing that maybe you and I could... Well, it doesn't matter what I think, does it? Does it ever?
Of course it damn well mattered. But you're always too full of self-pity to notice. 19. That's how old I was when I was expecting Debbie. 19, Ken. You were inside. I had no husband, no job. I had nothing.
Don't you think I knew that? What the hell do you think I was thinking about all those years? 6 times, Marion. You visited me 6 times in the first year, and then nothing but a few lousy letters.
Because I couldn't bear to see you in that place. Because every time we said goodbye, I could see it was tearing you apart. I couldn't take it anymore. I knew what you were going through. God, how I knew. You wonder why I hate prisons. After what they did to you. After what they did to us.
Well, we can't pretend it never happened, can we?
I want my husband back. I want my family together, Ken.
there's anyone around here anymore, might as well be in the bloody pound.
You got me, Lizzie.
Chrissie?
Yeah? Would you like to go and pack your bags?
You mean I've got it? I'm getting out. Oh, that's bloody brilliant.
Oh, that's real good, Chrissie. Give my love to Elizabeth, won't you?
Of course I will. I'm only allowed to see her one day a week. Well, that is till I've proved I'm a good mother.
You'll have her back in two shakes of a lamb's tail.
Well, Lizzie, honey, if you need a reference, just ring us up, huh?
Yeah, I'll do that. No hard feelings, eh?
Good luck.
You too.
I'd like 5 minutes alone with her, if that's okay. I don't want her to feel I'm letting her down.
It's not going to be easy to keep her interested. I don't seem to have the same rapport with her as you do.
Well, you'll have her on side as long as she can trust you. But she's going to need a hell of a lot of support. And she's got to keep up those projects, Dave.
I'll do my best. I just wish I could change her mind.
I'd appreciate it if you kept in touch. Let me know how she's getting on, will you?
Will do.
Yeah, well, it all seems to be there.
This is what you earned. Less deductions, $205.
Is that all?
The amount you worked, you're lucky to get that much.
I've got a lot of things I'd like to say to you, Miss Bennett, but I'm too much of a lady.
You'll be back inside, Latham. 5 years on parole. You'll be lucky to last 5 days.
Like hell.
Hurry up, Chrissie. Sign out and you can go.
The only way I'll end up back in here is if I see you out there. Because if I do, I'm going to wipe that smug grin right off your face.
Chrissie.
I don't know how you sleep at nights, Miss Bennett, knowing how everyone hates your guts.
What your sort think doesn't interest me, Latham. But I'll remember you. And when you're sent back to Wentworth, I'll be waiting.
I'll drop in tomorrow and see how you've settled in.
Oh, thanks, Mrs. Morris, for speaking up for me. You know, and, well, everything.
See you, Mrs. Morris.
Goodbye, Mick.
Oh, I can't wait for you to see the flat.
Look, will you stop treating me like I'm some sort of flaming invalid?
I had to come to a decision last night, Bea. It wasn't easy because it means letting down someone that I care about. I won't be working here anymore. What you were saying about the right person holding on no matter what you've got to do. Marion and I are going to give it another go. It's a gamble. We both know we'll have to work at it. There's got to be give and take on both sides. Marion's going to try and accept my job, and I said I'd slow down a bit. Which means that I'll just be doing my regular work. Oh, hell be, if it was anyone else but you. I don't want you to feel I'm letting you down.
I can do anything I put my mind to. I'm strong, remember?
I wouldn't mind betting you had something to do with this. Now, I don't know what you said to Marion, but it seems as though you've got our whole family back together again.
A little old matchmaker me, that's all.
I couldn't repay you if I spent a lifetime trying. Look, if ever you need anything, or a friend, just because I won't be working here doesn't mean that I won't keep in touch.
I'm sure the governor will be very interested in this.
She already knows, Miss Bennett. I won't be advising you anymore.
All the more reason why you should be supervised. I suggest you leave. Now.
I haven't finished speaking to B yet.
Oh, that's all right. I think you said it all. Be happy, huh?
Please understand.
Yeah, sure. You know, the funny thing is, it seems to be me that has the difficulty of making people understand.
My God, B, I'm sorry.
Old Bennett said Ken's not coming back no more. Is that true? What happened, love?
Leave me alone, Lizzie. Oh, hell. I never even kissed the man. How can I be in love with him?
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around, last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known. Till I had to face the nightmare. When morning comes around.